My name's Troy, and I'm a magician. But this show is not about magic. It's about these. Smartphones, tablets, and computers.
We use them every day to keep in touch and to get online.
But what if someone decided to exploit them? I'm talking about hackers and scammers. And for the next hour, actually me.
I'm going to take control of people's social media and turn their online world upside down.
I'm going to be in so much trouble because of this.
My targets are the oversharers, the careless.
What the bloody hell is that?
And those that don't take the information seriously.
No way!
And let's face it, that's most of us.
Some will get a lesson they'll never forget.
It's going to be on the internet forever. That's kind of scary.
Passwords, they're a part of everyone's lives. The average person has 19 accounts that need one. And if you're like me, you probably have loads more. Too many to remember.
And even if a password is strong, it can easily fall into the wrong hands.
So right now, I'm in probably one of the most iconic parts of London, Piccadilly Circus. But I'm not here to do magic today. I'm here to try something else. What's all about passwords? You know, we use passwords all the time.
Okay, yeah.
On our social media, online banking, emails.
Okay.
So I'm assuming you've got quite a few passwords for those kind of things, right? Think about the password you use for your email. Okay. Would you say it's quite secure?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay. It's actually a survey of the most commonly used passwords. And I want to see if it matches yours. Yeah, we got those cards? Okay. So, the first one is ABC123.
Yeah.
Is that your password?
No.
Huh?
No.
Okay, let me show you another one. Monkey, is that your password?
No.
That's good, because hackers will use these kind of passwords first. Try one more. 1234567.
No.
No?
No.
You sure?
Positive.
Your password's a bit more secure than that,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, secure, yeah.
That's good, that's good. Now, obviously, I can't get it here.
Yeah.
But I'm gonna try and see if these guys can get it.
Okay.
I want you to look at him, okay? Look in his eyes. What kind of password would he go for? Would he choose? On the count of three, I want you to yell it out, okay? On the count of three, all right? One, two, three.
River 22!
No way! How?
What was his password? The whole of Piccadilly Circus is your password.
Oh, you got to change it.
I'm changing it.
That's a good idea.
I didn't just get his password, I also got this guy's. This girl's.
I guess you better go and change that then.
And his too.
What the f***? Oh shit! That is crazy!
Now this might look like magic, but it's not. It's about computers, public ones that we don't own or control. Before filming with me in Piccadilly, these guys were asked to wait in a hotel cafe, which had this perfectly innocent looking computer. But this computer had something not so innocent on it. It's called a keylogger. It's a little gadget, or in our case, a piece of software that spies on what people type. It takes seconds to install, and you might never know it's there. While my guests waited, some of them checked their email accounts, and the keylogger recorded every single word they typed, including, of course, their email passwords. All I had to do then was get a crowd together and tell them where to look.
One, two, three.
River 22! Oh.
No way!
I do not have the slightest clue what just happened there.
Have you been on any, like, computer recently?
Huh? Yes, I was, actually. Oh, shit. In the cafe. I was on the computer in the cafe.
What did you do?
I signed in. Okay. I see.
Passwords need to be secure. They're of massive value to criminals. Last year, more than £40 million was stolen from people in Britain. And that's mainly because hackers had access to information like passwords.
So of course, you would never tell anyone your password, especially someone you've just met on the street. Would you?
Excuse me, do you mind if I ask you a question?
That's fine.
My name's Troy, by the way.
Right,
nice to meet you. I'm raising awareness about strong, secure online passwords.
Yes.
Okay, is there a password that you use on like a daily basis?
Yeah, I would say yes.
Yeah?
Yeah.
How strong would you say it is?
It's quite strong, yeah.
Yeah, what is it?
I don't want to like say it.
That's fine, a lot of people do get a bit anxious about saying their password, but it's fine.
Okay, it's frog.
Yeah.
It.
Frog it.
And then it's 123, and then it's two, and it's two question marks.
Oh, wow. Yeah. So that is pretty secure.
Thank you.
Okay. Wow. Is there a main one that you use all the time?
Yeah. Mahala?
Mahala?
Yeah?
Yeah?
Three sixes?
Three sixes. So Mahala 666. Any capitals in there?
Nope.
No?
Oh, what's your one?
Blackbird.
Blackbird?
Yeah.
Is that all one word?
Yeah. Oh no, it's got an underscore between the black and the bird.
Riaz
786110.
Yeah.
All lowercase words?
Capital.
Capital.
Penny Fields 48.
Penny. Dollar as in ghetto dollar, as D-O-L-L-A.
No, the symbol dollar.
Mine is house 1796 with a capital H.
Okay. Why would you just tell me? That's crazy. Even if someone offers you chocolate, you don't give them away. Out of 1 to 5, how strong would you say it is? 5 being 5 chocolates, 1 being 1 chocolate.
It's probably a 2.
A 2?
Yeah.
Oh man, what is it?
Bobster.
Bobster?
Yeah.
Is that all lowercase?
One capital.
What was the B?
Yeah.
One capital. Okay. There you go, man.
Nice.
Bobster, capital B. What is it?
Hannah Montana.
Hannah Montana?
Yeah.
What, is that all lowercase?
Yeah. Well, wow. There's like 2 numbers at the end.
What's the numbers?
1, 2.
I'll give you 2 chocolates for that.
I made it when I was 12. Oh, thank you. And I'm like, who's going to think of Hannah Montana?
Exactly.
Thank
well,
you.
Everyone that's watching this for a start, would you say it's particularly strong? Out of 1 to 5.
I'd say 5.
You say 5?
Yeah.
Yeah? What is your password?
Transit Sport 46.
Wow, that is pretty strong.
It is.
Is that all lowercase letters?
Yep.
Or?
All lowercase.
All lowercase. Mind you, it's not that strong now it's been on TV. Now, I'm glad to say not everyone was as happy to tell me their passwords. Hey, what's the main one that you use?
You want me to actually say it?
Yeah, you can say it, yeah.
No, but if I say it, then it's not secure anymore.
How strong would you say it is?
Given that I've been hacked twice in the last couple of months.
Oh, really? Have you had to change your password?
Yeah, I had to change it, yeah.
What is that password?
Nice one.
Oh, and by the way, this is the list of the top 10 most used passwords. Any of these look familiar? These are the first ones hackers will try.
We all rely on the internet for pretty much everything that we do. It's just part of life. But that's exactly why criminals want to hijack it. It's actually pretty easy for hackers to take over computers and hold them to ransom. Let me show you what I mean.
I've arranged for hidden cameras to be rigged in this office reception. This is Graham, an actor who's pretending to be the boss of this company.
Hi.
And this is Paige, who works for a temping agency.
Any calls, please just take a message.
She knows nothing about the cameras and she's about to have a very bad day at work.
If it's urgent, you can give me a call. So this is my number. Feel free to use the internet. Just kind of look busy if you can.
Okay, stop it.
Oh, one more thing. I am expecting some dinner. So when it arrives, if you could just give me a call.
Okay. You know.
Great,
right,
thanks so
thank
much,
you
Paige.
Very much, Graham.
Thanks, take care.
Hi.
Fix your phone, Graham.
This guy isn't just here to deliver a pizza. He's also got something quite exciting for Paige.
Your pizza's arrived?
It'll be right down there.
Okay,
Paige.
Thank you. Bye.
I'll give you one of these as well. It's an amazing offer we've got going on. It's World Pizza Day today. If you go to that website, you can download a voucher and you can redeem it any pizza place in the country.
Smashing, so, thank you so much.
It's a really, really good offer. You've seen it on Facebook, it's been all over.
No.
Yeah.
World Pizza Day? Who could resist?
Don't forget the voucher, free pizza.
Thank you.
To claim a free meal, Paige just has to visit a website and download a voucher. Simple. We've actually gone to quite a lot of trouble here. Let's hope she likes pizza. Now here's the thing. When you download anything from a website you don't know, very bad things can happen. There are more than 10,000 computer viruses in existence, with 200 new ones being discovered every month. And Paige has just downloaded one.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God.
Oh my God. We all rely on the internet, but so do hackers and scammers. And today, I'm gonna show you how.
Oh my God.
Receptionist Paige is in a world of pain. She took a flyer from a pizza delivery guy.
If you go to that website, you can download a voucher and you can redeem it any pizza place in the country.
Went to a website she's never heard of and downloaded a virus. Her system has been hijacked by a hacker. This is known as a ransomware attack.
Oh my God.
The computer is locked, and unless the victim pays money, the hacker will destroy all their files. And Paige is about to meet him.
Listen to me very carefully. You've downloaded a virus from a website and your computer has now been hacked.
Oh my gosh.
The system is locked and controlled by me. Get off the phone.
Oh my God.
If you do as I say, everything will be fine. If you don't do what I say, I will destroy all the files on this computer, your entire network, including the backup server. Do you understand?
Yeah. I'm literally gonna cry.
If you want this all to go away, you need to transfer me £5,000.
I don't have that money.
Do it from the company account.
I'm an agency staff. I've literally just sat in this desk.
£1,000. Really, all I want is some money, to be honest.
Honestly, you've just honestly picked the wrong person.
Can you not? Get onto the company account.
No,
you could just, I don't know, just ping across a couple of hundred or something.
No, genuinely. Oh. I don't have that money and now I'm going to be in so much trouble because of this.
Bloody typical.
So, did the gentleman that gave me this, is he part of your crew?
You don't need to know these details.
Okay, I'm sorry. I'm really sorry.
You don't always get to talk to your hacker, but £3 million a year are stolen by scammers using software like this. Luckily for Paige, the guy in the mask doesn't really want her money. He just wants to have a bit of fun. What will Paige do to make this horrible situation go away?
Look, I've got a little while until my next hack, so what about you, I don't know, tell me a joke or something?
I don't know any jokes, oh God.
Okay, just for my own entertainment, just so I can get something out of this, because I'll be honest, I've put a lot of time into this. Can you call the boss for me?
Right now?
Call the boss, but what I want you to do is, when he comes down, I want you to tell him that this is the best day of your life. And I want you to bow at him and call him Treacle. And then I'll go away.
But that...
Then I'll go away.
Okay.
Hello?
Hi, Graham. I'm sorry to disturb you. Could you possibly come downstairs?
Yes, I'll be right down. Thanks.
Okay, smashing. Thank you. Thanks.
I'm kind of busy upstairs. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, fun's over. The hacker's gone and the screen is back to normal.
I don't mean to think I'm absolutely crazy, but yeah, no, there was genuinely a man right. with a mask and everything. It was terrifying.
Well, if it happens again...
Okay, that's fine. It won't happen again, hopefully. No.
Okay.
But, yeah.
Thanks, Paige.
Now I think I'm crazy.
I think we'd better put Paige out of her misery. Did somebody mention free pizza?
Free pizza, we left. Open that up.
I don't really want to. What? This isn't even funny. Are you joking? I don't know.
Surprise!
The tragedy is that Paige still hasn't had any actual pizza.
I just thought it was one of those automated things until I picked up the phone and he said, put the phone down. And I was like, oh my gosh, like this is a system takeover now. What on earth do I do?
Get off the phone.
Oh my God. Don't just click if you see something for free. And definitely don't do it unless it's your computer because you could seriously lose companies thousands.
Sometimes it's good to surprise people. Come at them in a way that they're not expecting. Let's just say, I've gone to a lot of trouble with this next one.
In fact, I've organised a whole live theatre evening in central London and invited over 400 people. Right now, they're watching a performer called Madame Electra. She claims to have supernatural powers.
Now, many people would say that I'm a psychic. It's like I am getting messages, snapshots, short movies, images, comments. They flicker through my head all the time.
While all this is happening out front, I'm actually in a hidden control center backstage.
Now, I know this looks like some sort of psychic performance, but not everything is as it seems. Trust me.
All right, come up and join me. And I'm going to give you the microphone. You don't need to do much with it until I ask you. Then only answer yes or no.
I feel like I've got a movement going on here.
Have you got a black cat?
Yeah,
I thought so. Stay where you are. That's lovely. It feels like a bit scratchy. You've got a tattoo of a vine running down the side of your body, haven't you?
In fact, Madame Electra seems to know all sorts of private stuff about people.
Have you ever lived at number 34?
Yes.
Does the name Alexander mean anything to you?
It's my middle name.
So, what's really going on? Well, Madame Electra is definitely getting her information from somewhere, but it's not from spirits or some sort of supernatural ability. Nope, it's just from the internet.
You've got a black cat?
Yeah, I thought so.
You've got a tattoo of a vine running down the side of your body, haven't you?
Yeah. You see, all of Madame Electra's information was actually posted online by the audience or their friends. They don't know it, but we've looked every one of them up and in many cases found some pretty personal information.
Does the name Alexander mean anything to you?
It's my middle name.
And is your mum called Janine?
Yes.
Yep, it's right there on a certificate you posted online.
I'm getting the number 34. Would adore. Have you ever lived at number 34?
Yes.
He didn't just live there. He posted a photo of the front door when he moved in.
Callie, do you like superheroes?
Yeah.
Yeah? Because you've got a Batman symbol tattooed on the bottom of your foot, haven't you? Yeah, you do.
Right now, the audience is in the dark. I will tell them what's really going on. But not before one major oversharer in the audience gets the shot of her life.
Now, it's one thing hijacking information from people in the theatre, but posting private or embarrassing stuff on open profiles can actually affect you in real life. I went out looking for people that do exactly that, and I found them.
Four of them, to be exact. They were invited to London so I could teach them a bit of a lesson. They're being secretly filmed during a job interview at a marketing company.
I did musical theatre at college. And okay. I was quite active within like designing and that kind of thing.
I have to have social skills to level of getting on with a variety of people.
Yeah, I'm quite fun and bubbly.
Of course, they're all on their best behaviour, but who wouldn't be in an interview? There's just one little problem. There is no marketing company. There is no job. And this guy's not the boss. He's an actor called Barry, and he's here to make them squirm. He's looked up every embarrassing photo they've put on their open social media profiles. 45% of companies now do this. A career advice survey found embarrassing photos are the number one reason why people don't get a job. Not only does Barry know all about these guys, he's actually projecting the ugly truth on the wall behind them.
So what we're looking for here at Digital Age is a certain type of person. We don't want anyone who's too self-obsessed, you know, people who are real show-offs or posers. How would you describe yourself in terms of personality?
I'd say I do have quite a big personality. Doesn't mean I'm, you know, too much out there or like showing off or anything.
What? Like posting a naked selfie in the shower or something?
So you wouldn't consider yourself a show-off or a poser?
No.
Okay. In terms of discretion, social media now seems to be you get people who are just posting everything from what they're having for dinner and then getting rid of their dinner later on. You know,
so annoying.
How would that apply to you? Are you quite discreet?
I use social networking to talk to my friends or to see what everyone's going on.
But you wouldn't use it to post inappropriate photos or anything like that?
No.
Not like this then. Yeah, classy. Chloe also put some pretty embarrassing stuff online.
Do you smoke?
I do.
Heavy smoker? Or?
No, not particularly.
No, okay. Any vices, anything we should know about gambling or drinking or anything like that?
No.
No, okay.
Really? Keeping confidential data safe is very important these days.
How seriously do you take data protection?
I know all about it, really. You can't disclose anything.
What, like putting a driving license with a name, address and date of birth on Twitter?
So you wouldn't compromise your own personal data in any way whatsoever. We've had employees before out with clients and they've had a few drinks and next minute they're effing and blinding and it's hugely, hugely embarrassing.
Yeah.
Fuck! Oh, shit!
No effing or blinding there then.
And even after a drink, you could sort of rein that in.
Yeah.
If you were in a social situation, how could you ensure that you act in a responsible manner?
If you're all drinking together and everything, just know your limits.
Yeah, so don't post stuff like, I don't even know what that is. Remember, this has all been posted by them on their open profiles.
Oh.
They've been telling Porky's the whole time, so they're gonna get a bit of a shock when they see what Barry has under that box.
It's just a very simple lie detector test. Middle finger. Okay, is that comfortable?
Yeah.
So just run over some of the questions that we spoke about. Do you take data protection and personal data seriously?
Yes.
Do you indulge in gambling?
No.
On a night out, would you say that you're well behaved?
Yeah. Sometimes.
Do you ever post inappropriate pictures on social media?
No. Why is that going off? That went mad.
Would you describe yourself as a binge drinker?
No. Yes.
I think it's time to show them what's on the wall behind them.
Oh my God, that is so embarrassing.
That doesn't look like a man who isn't a poser to me.
Oh my God. Pictures of me naked, pictures of me posing, and I was just thinking in my head, like if he actually knew, like my Facebook, I'm definitely not what he's looking for.
I'm definitely going to think about what I post online now. It's going to be on the internet forever, and anyone can have it. That's kind of scary.
After the break, this girl realises she should have read the small print.
You accepted the terms and conditions by connecting to the Wi-Fi.
And these guys found out their selfie pics have a life of their own.
How the fuck did my picture get on the fucking metro?
I'm taking over people's social media and hijacking their online identities. If you want to use apps or get online, you normally have to tick a box agreeing to some terms and conditions. But does anyone really read any of that stuff? Let's find out.
I'm carrying out a little experiment in this bar. Customers can use the free Wi-Fi as long as they agree to the terms and conditions. And they're a bit unusual, to say the least.
Can I get anything to drink?
Yeah,
can I
have a green tea?
Yeah, and
coffee, please.
Cool.
Thank you. So what's the name of the Wi-Fi? Far Rockaway. I'm connected.
There you go.
Thank you.
Did you get on the Wi-Fi all right?
Yeah.
Did you connect to it?
Yeah.
Cool.
This girl has just connected to the free Wi-Fi, and that means she's accepted the conditions. They're 32 pages long, so I'm pretty sure she hasn't even looked at them. Actually, 73% of people say they don't read the small print. And only 12% actually understand what it says. So what has she agreed to? Well, the waitress is going to bring over some clues.
I'm just gonna leave this here.
That's fine.
It's quite heavy, but I think between two of you, you should probably be able to carry it. Did you get here on the tube or did you drive?
Tube.
Okay, they don't really like the tube, but it should be fine, it should be fine.
I don't get it. What are we carrying here for? I'm so confused right now.
Yeah, I forgot to bring these. So these are the food pellets. They love them. Just leave those there, and then you can just keep that at home with the hay as well. That's okay. Cool.
She's speechless. Actually, she's not, because she even films herself and puts it online.
So if everything's all right, we're just gonna bring them in, if that's all right. Just gonna bring them in?
So what has this customer actually agreed to that involves hay and food pellets?
I don't wanna see what she's bringing.
She's about to find out.
So this is tea, and this is C. Oh, here we go, just round here. So basically, they'll just eat the food pellets, and then you can take the hay home. And then here we go. This is the tea, so that's yours there.
I'm a bit confused.
And they're yours, basically, to take home. With the Wi-Fi, because you logged onto the Wi-Fi.
Yeah.
And then in the terms and conditions of the Wi-Fi that you read, it says, with a charitable donation, so you're going to be taking home some goats to adopt. Did you read the terms and conditions of the Wi-Fi?
No, did you?
No. Oh, they're really going for it. And that is actually your responsibility now, technically. They've done a bit of business there. I'll just go and get the terms and conditions now so I can show you. So if you just want to hold on to them.
Oh my God, it's different.
So here's the terms and conditions here.
It's licking me.
So there it is, it's the Charitable Animal Trust Initiative. You accepted the terms and conditions by connecting to the Wi-Fi, so it does say on here that they're available for you to read if you want to read them, and you didn't read them, but you're still legally bound to the contract by connecting to the Wi-Fi. So you'll be taking two goats home, as stated in the contract.
She's going to have a lot of fun getting them home. Do they even allow goats on the tube?
Look, he's so weird.
Nobody can read all those pages of conditions, but if you don't, you might be the one taking home the goats.
I think everyone would have fallen for this, to be honest. It is ridiculous to be expected to read all of this, to be honest, especially on the spot. If you gave me a week, then yeah, I wouldn't have signed up to the Wi-Fi at all.
Selfies, you know we all take them, but unless we make them private, anybody could see them or even download them. There are instances of people's photos being stolen and used abroad in random adverts, and that gave me an idea.
Once you put your face out there, there's no telling where it might end up. Let me show you. I'm gonna need a special hat for this one.
So today I'm in sunny Walthamstow, and if you can't tell already, I'm actually in disguise as a taxi driver. Got my tweed hat, my tweed jacket, and my main man Phil here. Good, how you doing, man? He's gonna teach me how to drive one of these taxis.
Once I've got the hang of driving around in a black cab, it's time to pick up my first fare.
Where are you fellas off to?
M1 Sneaker.
M1 Sneaker, oh yeah, I think I know where that is.
This is Sunny. He's 24 years old and he loves taking photos of himself, which he then posts online. Today, his face is going to get more attention than he ever expected.
I recognise you from somewhere.
Who?
You.
Me?
Yeah. You was in today's paper, right?
Isn't that me?
Yeah.
No, I wasn't.
I've got the metro right here, mate. I'm sure it's you.
No, it's not.
You're doing some sort of product launch today.
Was I?
Yeah. That's you right there, isn't it?
What the?
So you're doing a product launch today. Is that you?
Yeah, that is me, but from what?
Mate, you're doing a product launch. I've seen your stuff just around the corner in the market.
What?
Are you a celebrity or something?
No.
Mate, come on, you're in the paper. You must be.
I'm so confused.
You're doing a product launch.
Wait, let me see.
That's you, mate, right?
No, I'm so confused.
Wait. Well, the product launch is just down there. I've seen a poster with your face on it.
Nah.
The thing's round here. There's like balloons and everything. What product are you launching, yeah?
What product? I don't even know.
Go around there, where those trees are, turn to the left, you'll see it. Well, I've turned off the meter for you, I'll wait here. So if you want to have a look.
How the fuck did my picture get on the fucking metro?
Right.
That newspaper page wasn't real, but many people have really had their photos stolen and used in adverts. Even on porn sites.
Wow. Oh, wow.
I'm very confused, man. Why is my picture there? Why is my picture there?
So we're promoting a new hemorrhoid
cream
today?
What? No, but why is my picture there?
Yep, that's right. Sunny is advertising Amazing H hemorrhoid cream. Does it work? Well, just look at the relief on that face.
Coming down to see it all.
Thank you for coming
down. Thank you so much.
What?
Do you want to take a leaflet?
Okay.
But have you not had hemorrhoids?
What's hemorrhoids?
Like,
on the back side?
Yeah.
I ain't had none of that.
But it says to you have.
Because I never thought that itch would go away.
What the hell?
Lucky for Sunny, he's arrived just in time for the grand launch.
3, 2, 1.
Wouldn't want anyone to miss this advert. There's even a local news crew that turned up to speak to the star of the campaign.
Oh, shit!
Sunny, if we were to get you to give a message to other people who might be suffering from hemorrhoids like yourself, what would you say to people?
Just use the cream. Just use the cream.
Not even everyone's laughing at me, I'm a laughing stock.
This was so much fun. We did the whole thing again with Rhiannon.
Why is my Facebook profile picture up there? Like, what the hell?
Who swore?
What the hell?
A lot.
Like, what the bloody hell is that?
That's not even my hand. Like, at least put a bit of fake nails on or something. Like, what the hell?
And we also did it with Jake, who was lost for words. He even had to call his mummy.
Mum, there's literally a screen with my face on it.
And if you don't want to advertise hemorrhoid cream or another product, and I'm guessing you don't, just make your profile private.
I'm ruined. Ruined. Well, I didn't know I had him with.
Because I never thought that itch would go away.
It's from a Facebook account. It's weird thinking about it, that people can just get your photos and use them for whatever.
Hemorrhoid cream. It's amazing.
Well, obviously, anyone can steal your own identity as well, so, you know, maybe I left my profile open and you start making it private.
You know, people put their whole lives online. Where they're going, what they're doing, even what they're eating. Such as this blogger called Becky, who's going for lunch. Like many people do, she's tweeted the name of the restaurant.
Going for an amazing lunch with Jessica Bolton because I can, at the Veli, smiley face.
But should you really let complete strangers online know exactly where you are? Becky's about to find out why that's a bad idea.
OMG, that's literally just around the corner from me. I should eat there too, lol.
Oh.
She's got a new follower.
I'm really scared. Please don't come around here and eat.
Not only that, but they've been standing outside watching Becky and her friend.
But that's taken through the window.
After the break, Becky comes face to face with her stalker.
I'm really scared.
and one oversharer is about to have a home invasion. I'm hijacking people's social media to show them what can go wrong and turn their world upside down. Blogger Becky has let all her followers know where she's having lunch by tweeting the name of the restaurant. Unfortunately for her, one online follower has decided to also follow her in real life.
Well, that's taken through the window. I'm a bit freaked out.
As soon as Becky's alone, the stalker comes over to say hello.
Excuse me. Hi, sorry. Are you Becky Charlotte?
Yeah.
I love your blog. I read your blog all the time.
Okay.
And I just saw you were here and...
Are you a super foodie fan?
Yeah, I just work around the corner and I thought I'd come down and eat here as well. What have you ordered?
We've ordered, I can't even remember the name, but it's like the baked pasta.
Baked pasta. Nice to meet you.
Okay, that was a bit weird. Looks like the follower wants a photo with Becky. Maybe close-up is better.
I'm so sorry to interrupt you again. I was just wondering if you would mind having a photo together?
No, that's fine.
Is that okay? Maybe you could like give me a bit of your food on my fork, because I know you don't want to use your fork.
I hope you like pasta.
Yeah, I do. It's so nice.
It
I got the
really
same
good.
As you. Yeah, I got exactly the same. Yeah, yeah.
Don't eat it. Don't eat it. She's eating it.
Oh, perfect.
Don't forget your fork.
Oh, yeah. Thanks. I'll see you. Yeah.
You see, by telling her followers, most of whom she's never met, exactly where she is, she's opened herself up to all kinds of strangers turning up.
So I just tweeted the photograph and my friends are really excited and they're actually coming down as well. Yeah, because we all got these t-shirts, done of you. We just love your blog and they're here.
Oh my God.
Let's see how she handles a room full of complete strangers surrounding her.
I should give you a t-shirt, one of our t-shirts.
Do you follow him on this?
Hell yeah.
Yeah.
I love it.
Ready, guys? Oh my God, amazing.
Love it. Yeah.
Do you want me to do a selfie?
Oh,
yeah,
amazing.
Amazing. Oh,
we should probably go.
Giving away your location is a risky business because you just never know who's following you.
Anyone can find you, turn up, they could do nasty things, they could be horrible to you. You don't always want everyone to know where you are all the time.
I'm backstage at a theatre evening that I've set up. The 400 strong audience think they're watching a psychic.
Alexander, mean anything?
Many have given away private information on social media, but one person here has gone even further.
And it's you. Come and join me on stage, please. Give this lady a big round of applause.
This is Lucy, and she hasn't just posted stuff about her life, she's given away something else, something criminals could use.
Now, I want you to imagine that you are sat in your living room.
First, Madame Electra is going to tell us something that she shouldn't really be able to know. What furniture she's got in her front room.
Two-seater sofas. You've got a brown leather, yes,
yes
or no? Good.
Seems to be right.
Now, you have a mirror in your house and it's large and you've got shards of angular shapes. Does that make sense to you, Lucy?
Yes, it does.
Yeah.
Yep, that's also right.
I'm picking up on some pictures. You've got a picture of one horse, and it's black, and it's got a red halter on it. Your other picture is of a bay horse, and it's got a black halter on it. Yeah?
Now, she doesn't know this because she's seen photos on the internet. It's more scary than that. Madame Electra has actually seen her furniture.
There's something on your sofa, and I mean...
Okay. I'm gonna go in and tell everyone the truth.
That's it.
Whoa. Can I just stop this for 1 second, please? Sorry. Guys, do you find this a bit too good to be true? Yeah? I think it's a bit too good to be true, personally. I'm sorry to interrupt, but this whole thing has been a setup. Okay? Her name's not Madame Electra. Her name's actually Ailey, and she's an actress. She's not a psychic whatsoever. Lucy, stand up for me. Ali, thank you very much. I'll take it from here. Right. Lucy.
Yeah.
Now, Ali was, Madame Electra was giving you a description of your living room.
She was, yeah.
Was it pretty accurate?
Very.
Very accurate. Yeah. It's almost as if she could see the furniture in your living room.
Mm-hmm.
Well, she could actually see the furniture in your living room. If you turn around, it's actually behind you. That is your actual furniture from your living room. Your rug, your pictures, your jigsaw puzzle.
Oh my God. Embarrassing.
Don't be embarrassed. It's nice furniture. I like it. It's good. Do you want to know how we got your furniture?
I'd quite like to.
Okay. Do you use social media a lot?
No.
Would you say you're a bit of an oversharer? I would say you're a massive oversharer. I've seen posts of your wedding, okay. Which is right here.
Oh, God.
I've seen posts of your nights out. I've seen posts of your glamour shots.
Oh, yeah.
That's pretty nice. Pretty nice. I've seen posts of your festive jumper. My mum's got exactly the same one. It's pretty nice. But that's the thing. You're a bit of an oversharer, and that's how we got this information.
I can't believe you've got my furniture.
Exactly.
We already know Madame Electra's not a psychic. I should probably tell the audience too.
This whole evening, Madame Electra hasn't been getting information from the spirit world. She's actually been getting information from the online world. Okay, I'll let that soak in for a second. I'm talking about your social media, the things that you post up, your pictures, your videos, your statuses. People posting pictures of their houses, their security, what their locks look like, where they put their keys. It's crazy.
Lots of people post photos on the internet, but Lucy's gone one step further. She's actually told the world the location of where she lives.
You actually posted a picture of your living room and it was geotagged. So I knew exactly what town you lived in, right? You can have a look for yourself. It's right there, that's your living room, right?
Yeah.
Not only that, she also posted a picture of her actual house. Anyone with Street View can just look it up online. All we needed to know was when she was going to be out. And she told us that too.
You actually tweeted something, said you're in London today, and we knew that you wasn't gonna be at home.
A survey of ex-burglars found that 80% of them claimed social media was being used by current criminals to find victims' houses.
So I took the liberty of going to your lonely, vulnerable home and stealing your furniture. But there is good news. There is good news. Your furniture's here, it's safe. But I can't say that for the rest of your house. Because I let a few people know that you weren't at home.
Okay.
Come on, take a look at this.
Oh, no.
Yep, there's girls kissing. There's a party going on. They don't break your chandelier.
It's
expensive. Now, seeing that, how did that make you feel?
A little bit disturbed.
A little bit disturbed.
And a bit worried about my house.
Yeah. Will you think twice about posting so much information about yourself?
Yeah, probably.
Yeah? Probably. Okay. Well, look, Lucy, you've been great. Thank you very much. Guys, give her a round of applause. Thank you.
So, use the internet. It's part of our lives. And if you also use your head, you can avoid people like me taking control. Like I did by revealing embarrassing photos.
Oh my God.
That should be private, but really aren't.
Oh my God, that is so embarrassing.
Creating dodgy software with sketchy characters and masks.
Oh my God. I'm literally crying.
That hold computers to ransom. Writing terms and conditions that nobody ever reads, but that could really get someone's goat. Making people the face and the backside.
What the bloody hell was that?
Of some advert on a giant screen.
Oh.
And exposing secret information for the whole world to see.
No way!